Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, we're going to have another look at testing API resources, more specifically in the context of a one-to-many relationship. In our example, we have a post model and we will be creating comments on that post model using an API endpoint. Okay, so if we look at our route, you can see it uses a post method to the post comments endpoint, and that maps to the post comment controller class, and it uses the store method. It also has a name, comments.store. Okay, so now if we look at the store method in our post comment controller, you can see that it accepts a store post comment request, which is a custom form request. It also accepts the post, which is injected for us by Laravel using route model binding. Then it returns a new post comment resource and it accepts the first parameter as a comment. And we get the comment by using the post, which we receive from the route model binding, calling the comments relationship and then the create method on that comments relationship. And then what we pass in is the validated fields received from the form request. Now, if we look at the store post comment request, you can see it is a simple form request that validates the comment with three validation rules. Okay, so let's look at our comments relationship next. On our post model, we have a relationship set up, which is a has many relationship to the post comment class. Okay, lastly, let's look at the post comment resource. Now, the post comment resource returns the comment that gets created. In this example, we're also going to return the post, which is a new post resource, and it uses the post relationship on the comments model. And if we look at the post relationship on the comments model, you can see it is a belongs to relationship to the post class because the post comment belongs to the post. And the inverse of that is a post has many comments. Okay, great. Now that our setup is out of the way, let's go ahead and look at our actual test. Now, the first test says it should return an error when the required fields are not provided. And if you remember from our store post comment request, our comment would be the required field. So that is what we're going to test. Now, within our test, we create a post using the post factory. Then we post in the information to the comments.store endpoint, but we're not passing in any comment information to expect the error to be returned. And then we're going to assert that the response is unprocessable, which is a 422 error. And then we're going to take that response and place it in a snapshot, so we can see what the response looks like. And if we look at the snapshot, this is the response we expect from that endpoint. So let's go ahead and run PHPUnit to see what happens. And there we go. One test, two assertions, our test was successful. Now for our second test, it says it should successfully create a post comment and return the resource. Now again, In our test, we create a post using the post factory. Then we post that information to the comments.store endpoint. And now we're going to pass in the comment as a parameter. Then we're going to assert that our response is created, which also translates to a 201 status. Then we're going to assert the JSON structure that we receive back. And that should have a data key. It should then have the comment key, and then should have a post key, which translates to a post resource, and the post resource would have a name, a description, and a status. So just to go back to the post comment resource, so we're going to receive the comment, and then we're going to be a post, which is a post resource. And again, if we look at the post resource, you'll see that we require the name, or that we provide the name, description, and status, which we're going to test for in our JSON structure. Next, what we're going to check is the information that we receive back from our endpoint. We're going to make sure it is the information that we expect. So we use the assert JSON fragment and we check that the comment we receive is the comment we sent. And with the post resource, we expect it to be the information we created using the factory. And the last thing we want to check is that the information was actually persisted in the database when we accessed the endpoint. So we're using this, the assert database has. We then provide the comments, post comments table as the first parameter. And the second parameter is the entry we will be looking for. So we'll be looking for an entry that has a comment of the comment we've sent, which also has a post ID of the post we created using the factory. Okay, so let's run PHPUnit again to see if our tests are passing. Great, now we've got 2 tests and 12 assertions. Our second test was successful. Now, our third test says it should successfully update a post comment and return the resource. Now, in order to do this, I've set up a route, which is a patch route, to the post comments endpoint, which we provide the post and the comment, which then maps to the post comment controller and the update method. It also has name comments.update. You'll also see that I've placed it inside a group of scope bindings. Now, scope bindings basically just checks to see that this comment belongs to this post. This is something Laravel can do automatically for us. If you're unfamiliar with scope bindings, I'll leave a link in the description to a video I've got where I explain how scope bindings work and how we can use them. Okay, so let's look at our post comment controller update method. As you can see, it receives a form request, update post comment request. It receives the post from the route through route model binding. It also receives the post comment through route model binding. And then we use the update method on the comment model, and we pass in the request validated information, which only going to return the validated information from our form request. Now, if we go back and look at our test, we can see we create a post using the post factory, and then we create a comment using the comments relationship on the post model. Then we do a database assertion to check whether the post comments table has the information on the comment we've just created. We technically don't need to do this check because this is something we've checked in the test above. But as a double check, we can continue to do it. Then we patch the information to our route, which is the comments.update. We pass in the post and the comment. And we also pass in as a parameter the updated post comment. Then we assert that our response is okay because we're expecting a 200 response. Then we do the same assertion as our store test to check whether our JSON structure is the same. We then check whether our information we sent is the information we get back, which is done through the assert JSON fragment. Our last assertions checks whether the database is missing the information we created via the factory, and it has the information we've sent via the endpoint. And let's run PHPUnit to see what happens. And there we go. 3 tests, 24 assertions. Our third test was successful. And that's it for this episode, guys. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.